a magazine came out last week.
Yeah.
And I was in Kenya. So we decided to start our media tour in Kenya. We went to NTV, went to a number of TVs there in Kenya, and wow, they really appreciate our work. Yeah, man. Good stuff, good stuff. First of all, they appreciate our food, they appreciate our vibes, they appreciate our girls. Oh my God, my number one girls. My number is Mukama. Mukama.
Wow. All right, now, I've seen this being done by artists. Just like yourself, you just told us you've been on a media tour.
Yeah.
And why do you think it's very important for every artist to actually walk outside the boundaries of Uganda, at least for us?
Well, I think it's really important for an artist for exposure. You get exposed out and go beyond what you think you're in, you know? Get outside the box and see what's up out there. Because,
yeah.
To be honest, I met these guys, the writer Bambuzi Gang.
Yeah.
So we even did a song. They were so like, they had a big reception for Uganda.
We were actually here on the show sometimes.
Yeah, so when I went there, they were like, Mwana, I want my Chabaki, that is what we need to give you the best reception here.
Yeah.
Wow, they took me everywhere. I never but I got to our president.
Shout out to our people in Kenya, Mbuzi Gang in particular. Thank you.
Yeah,
big
up Jumpers, big up I Foolish, and big up Furthermore, big up Cedric Black Market.
Yeah.
Yo, big up all the artists in Black Market. You know, I went there at the Black Market offices,
yeah.
And I wanted to see how Black Market does in that side. It's really big there. So I wanted to know how they really do it out there.
Yeah.
They're really doing a great job, like reaching out to artists and sponsoring them and the
Now, Zex, I think even before you landed a breakthrough hit song, your fashion already stood out. I think around that time when you came through, you know, you were already in company with Bobby Wine. What does fashion mean to you? And I'm seeing, you know, still. The drip is on point. This is a custom made.
Yeah, this is a custom made.
What are you calling it?
We collaborated with my friend, it's called Mavo.
Yeah, Mavo Fashion. Mavo Style.
Mavo Fashion, yeah. You're big up on yourself, my brother Mavo. You're bad. Yeah, man, people should support. You were asking me about fashion, what it means to me. To me, fashion is the day to day life we live in. Because people always want to look fresh, people want to appear different to their people. So, fashion is every day to day look, you know. As you get out of your house, how you feel comfortable is how you're gonna get out. So to me, that's fashion. And another thing, fashion is a language.
Yeah.
Yes, I can speak to you through fashion. You understand what I'm talking about, like me, Wandala Mkwewenti. You definitely have to know that I'm from the hood.
Yeah.
But I
don't know
how I'm get a prime minister, by the way.
Oh yeah.
Yes. So to me, fashion is
Do you still create outfits? Because I remember that thing I vividly recall.
To be honest, I wanted to make myself at least different.
Yeah.
At least to look different. Because we're doing art, so we need to do art to the extra. We need to give art a bigger picture. So I believe if you're an artist, maybe a performer or a singer, you could still be a lot. You can be a boxer, you can be a runner, you can be a soccer player. Like I play soccer, I play boxing, like I do a lot of, I believe as long as you have talent, all talent can go through you. So you need to exercise everything. Yeah, you need to exercise everything because Man, above you have to see a self-service, man.
Oh, yes. We left with just a few minutes before we wrap up, but this is going to be my second last question. This new tune, Magazine, what inspired that vibe?
Well, the vibe is about how we're really losing our culture as Africans. Like, all over, we're not embracing our culture as the black people.
Yes.
So the main song for this song, the main reason for this song is embracing the African culture, the melanin. Talk about the melanin. I'm not talking about in particular only black ladies, because I've received questions they're telling me the only thing for the melanin ones. No, every person who is a black person has the melanin in their skin. So yes, let's preserve it. I had a question. A 1 gram of melanin costs $750.
One gram of melanin.
Yes. It costs $750. And 1 gram of gold is around, because it keeps going up and down. It goes 100 and something, but it can still reach the level of melanin. So I'm here to say that we should protect our skins more and embrace what we are and believe in what we are.
Oh yeah.
Yes.
Oh yeah. I like that. Yeah. Congratulations. Since I have a member from Firebase, I would also want to congratulate Anobian Lee.
Yo.
So
good. Oh my God. Oh my God. I was in Kenya. I didn't happen to be there. I was in Kenya, but I love you so much, Uncle Anobian. I love you so much, Mami Meha. May God bless you. Wallahi, I watch you sing on Wagala Allah. Wallahi.
All right, we have to wrap up this interview.
Yeah.
Coming up is the question and answer segment, which is coming on next. We're just going to play a little bit of this video, then right after that, we shall be getting 22 that one-on-one engagement.